An average human being is bombarded, or his mind is bombarded, at least 50,000 to 60,000 thoughts every single day. That is medical science research report. Our mind is bombarded by 50,000 to 60,000 thoughts every single day. Now my question is, how many thoughts you are actually aware in a day consciously? 10, 20, 50, 100, 1,000? Let us say I give you basically a over optimistic, let's say you are aware as optimistic observation estimation, let's say you are aware around 1,000 thoughts every single day. Now out of 50,000 thoughts which strikes your mind, you think that you are very much aware. Let's say you are aware of 1,000 thoughts, that is only 2% thoughts, which means 98% of the thoughts which strikes to your mind, you are totally unaware. I repeat, as per medical science research report, our mind is bombarded by 50,000 thoughts roughly to 60,000 thoughts every single day. And I'm saying, even if you are aware of 1,000 thoughts striking your mind every single day, you're aware, okay, this thought is striking my mind, that thought is striking my mind, and you're very conscious, still it leaves you 49,000 thoughts which you are not aware, which is almost equal to 98% of thoughts you are unaware. So if 98% thoughts you are unaware, basically it simply means that you are living a life, most people living a life totally unaware what is happening to them. And the problem does not end over here. Because 98% time you are unaware. So every time basically a thought is striking and you're unaware, you always react. And reaction is always negative. You can take only positive action basically when you're aware of something. And that's a fundamental reason to, that's a point to highlight that most people live a life which is totally they're unaware. And now this is the basically invention, or we'll say discovery of Buddha, when he said Buddha actually wanted each and every person should be fully aware 24 into 7. Even when we are sleeping, the yogis basically they have reached to that level, they are fully aware of what is happening inside. They might be sleeping, they are resting, but fully aware. I've actually made another video on this. But I think that was in Hindi, that Sari Duniya Soti Hai, Yogi Jagta Hai, the whole world is asleep, the yogi is awake, what exactly it means. So I've given much more detail in that video. I will put a link also in the description later. So Buddha basically wanted that you should be fully aware of it. Everything what is happening in your body, everything what is happening in your mind, every thought basically just striking you. And it's a lifetime practice. And there is a reason behind it, why basically Buddha emphasized was at the point of death, when the death is coming, and you are fully aware what is happening inside. So at the final moment, basically when you leave this body, you will be fully aware. And at that particular moment, when you are fully aware, you will have the option to choose which plane of existence you would like to take a next birth, whether human level or celestial level, either or Brahmic level or Deva level. And if you are not aware, which most of the people are not, because they have never done this practice of being fully aware or fully conscious. So unfortunately, most people ended up having a birth as a human level. They ended up having a birth at a lower plane. It could be basically like a ghost plane, or it could be animal plane, or it could be there are other two more planes. But if you basically practice this art of being conscious all the time, aware all the time, then you are your own master. And that's basically what Buddha says, you are your own master. But it's only when you're fully conscious of what is happening with you, how the thoughts are striking, and what is happening inside you. And that's a lifetime practice. And there's one more thing in that. It's very important to follow or to observe the moral code of conduct. So until and unless basically if your moral code of conduct is not you're not really established in that, it will be very difficult to basically develop a proper samadhi, and it will be very difficult to basically observe the actual reality and being established into that wisdom. Anyhow, The topic basically which I wanted to highlight was that the scientific explanation of why most people are living a life in unawareness is that even if you are aware of 1,000 thoughts, which is very difficult, you're still basically having 98% of the time you're living a life totally unaware. If you find this video informative, feel free to share it with your friends. If you would like to be notified for more informative videos in the future, feel free to subscribe to the channel and also press the bell icon so you get a notification whenever the new video is uploaded. Thank you very much for watching it.